Today, we try to answer a question that sometimes intrigues fans: the comparison between players from different eras. If there was a possibility to pit Roger Federer at peak performance and today's Jannik Sinner, how would the match end? Were the best Boris Becker or Pete Sampras stronger overall than a today's player around 100 like Cucanardi? It's hypothetical, but the data can help us understand better how much the tennis performance is getting better and better over the years. The average speed of tennis is continuously improving, and consequently, the average time between the shots of players has reduced. In 2002, the average was approximately 1.5 seconds, while in 2019, the tension speaks of 1.29 seconds. Today, in some matches, the threshold of one shot every 1.20 seconds is reached. The average speed of the first serve has increased significantly, but the average speed of the second even more. Among men, serves above 230 km per hour, therefore the 54 fastest serve server, have all been measured in the last 20 years except one. In 2021, 8 players exceed or equal the average speed of 200 km per hour with first serve. After 2 years, in 2023, there were 19. There were 9 players who exceed or equaled average of 165 with second serve in 2021. In 2022, 13. In 2023, 18. Another very striking fact is that in 2023, 133 players hit a serve measured above 200, while only 10 years ago, few managed to reach these peaks. Same trends for women, perhaps even more accentuated. For a few years now, several players have exceeded 200 km per hour as peak speed, and the fastest serves ever have almost all been recorded in the last decade, with an increase in average first and second serve speeds of around 20 km per hour, compared to the previous year of 2000s.
Whoa!
In addition, despite the increased speed, the average percentages of first and second serves increased slightly. Now there are 100 male players who are above 60% of first serves in the season. In 2013, there were 78, in 2000, 51. Furthermore, despite faster and more precise serves, the percentages of successful return have remained stable, which is another indication of the strong improvement in return and in the all-round performance. Another striking trend is that the number of average winners in a match is usually higher than in the past. In Sinner Medvedev in the final at the Australian Open 2024, there were 94 winning shots in 183 points. In the iconic final of 2004 Australian Open Federer-Safin, there were 54 winners in 206 points. Same year at Wimbledon, final between Roger and Roddick, there were 100 winners in 287 points. Also considering that in the past the first surfaces were faster than the current ones, that players often complain nowadays about slower balls, and that we examined 3 players from the past who focused a lot on the offensive game, the serve and the speed of the ball, these are significant data. Furthermore, we must also frame this data considering how much the athletic and defensive level the players has risen in the last 20 years, making a winner against Medvedev it's much more difficult than doing so against Safin, and some years ago, it could happen to find defensively limited and not exactly athletic players, while today these characteristics are difficult to accept in night-level tennis. Furthermore, if we talk about speed, consider that Sinner has an average forehand speed consistently around 130 km per hour, while Roger was within 120 and 125. Jannik's backhand travels slightly below 125, Roger's between 105 and 112. In 2023, Jannik recorded an average speed of 195 with first serve, with the impression that he has improved further in recent months, while for Roger, the career average speed was 175 km per hour. In the description of the video, you will find the data sources. Ball speed isn't everything, but if we connect it with the increase in serve percentage and the stability of ground strokes and return percentages, the comparison between Jannik and Rogers leans in favor of the Italian, yeah! But it is in the order of things, and the current potential number one is better than the one even a few years ago. No one knows how strong Roger Federer born 20 years later would have been, but as today I love Jannik, I feel lucky to have witnessed the wonder of Roger's era. If you like the video and are interested in why and how the number one of 2040 will be better than the current Djokovic or Sinner, subscribe to the channel and follow the next videos. See you next time.